गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल. आई एम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी के चेंगटे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, कलबुर्गी. डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक दैट इज जनरल कैरेक्टर्स एंड एज वेल एज क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ प्रोटोजोआ. नाउ टुडे बिफोर गोइंग टू द जनरल कैरेक्टर्स, फर्स्ट वी शुड नो द व्हाट आर द यूनिक कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोटोजोआ, दैट वी शुड नो. देन अगेन वी गो फॉर द जनरल कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोटोजोआ. In this protozoa, the first unique characters of protozoa is protozoa are the unicellular organisms. This unicellular type of organisms we can see only in the protozoa. We cannot see in other phylums. This is the most important unique characters that we have to found in phylum protozoa. Next come to the general characters of phylum protozoa. In these general characters of phylum protozoa, we have to study about all the habitat up to the development. What are the physiological activities? How the body structure of the protozoa? These all are we have to studied in the general characters of phylum protozoa. First we come to know that what is the protozoa. All of you know the meaning of the protozoa. Pro means first, zoa means animals. These first animals, they have appeared on the earth, that we call as phylum protozoa. These protozoa are a diverse group of unicellular eukaryotic animals, and these protozoans are coined by the word is the scientist, that is George August Goldfuss, in the year 1818. These all are protozoans are heterotrophic organisms, and they do not have the chlorophyll. Here in this phylum protozoa, you have see the examples of amoeba, paramecium, euglena. Here the structures are there, that is the amoeba, paramecium, and as well as euglena. These are the unicellular organisms comes under the examples of phylum protozoa. Now come to the characteristics of protozoa. In these characteristics, what we have to study, the first one is habitat and the structure of the organisms that present in the phylum protozoa, and what are the physiological characters, how they have to take place in the organisms, that we have to discuss about in the general characters of protozoa. First, the protozoans, the body consists of only mass of protoplasm, so they are called acellular or non-cellular or unicellular organisms. Already I have told in the unique characters, that is these protozoans are single celled animals. The single cell can do all the physiological activities. Now come to the habitat means where they have to live and what they have to eat, that we have to discuss here. In the habitat, mostly aquatic, either free living or parasitic animals, these animals are. Now come to the body structure of the phylum protozoa. In this body structure, the size are, most protozoans are the size of 1 to 10 micrometer long, means these all are microscopic organisms. We cannot see with the naked eye. We can only use the microscopic. Under the microscopic only we can see the protozoans organisms. And body of the protozoa is either naked, already I have told that naked, or covered by the pellicle. And come to the locomotion. How the locomotion of the protozoans animals? These locomotory organs are pseudopodia or cilia. Or sometimes in some animals, these locomotory organs are also absent. But when taken as examples of amoeba, the amoeba is in the amoeba, the locomotory organs are pseudopodia. In paramecium, you have take the locomotory organs are cilia. The different organisms, different locomotory organs we have to see. Next come to the nutrition. In nutrition, they are holophytic, like plant like structure, they have to feed. And next, holozoic, like animal like, they have to feed. And some, they are saprophytic or parasitic animals. Now come to the digestion. Digestion in the phylum protozoa, they are intracellular digestion. Intracellular digestion means digestion is present within the food vacuoles, that we call as intracellular digestion. Now come to the respiration. Respiration occurs through the body surface, because the single cell can do all the physiological activities. Therefore, the respiration is taken place by body surface. Osmoregulation means contractile vacuoles helps in the osmoregulation. This contractile vacuoles are helps for the osmoregulation process. In most protozoa, the cytoplasm is differentiated into ectoplasma. Their outer layer we call as ectoplasma and inner layer we call as endoplasma. The structure of cytoplasm is mostly seen in species with projecting pseudopodia such as amoeba. And now come to the last is reproduction. Reproduction occurs by both asexual and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction usually by the binary fission, and sexual reproduction usually by the conjugation. And the nucleus may be compact with diffuse chromatin, or vesicular with central or acentric chromatin and peripheral chromatin. And respiration is mostly anaerobic. Anaerobic means that is the absence of oxygen. Next come to the last one is the classification of protozoa. In this classification of protozoa, here there are the five classes are there. That is Sporozoa, Nidopora, Rhizopoda, Zoomastigopora. There are four classes are comes under classification of protozoa. And next class we have to discuss about the characteristics of all classes of protozoans. Thank you. ಆಯ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್.